great sign in heaven of Revelation chapter 12, verse 1. A great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. And she was with child, and she cried out, being in labor and in pain to give birth. Jesus calls such events fearful sights and great signs from heaven. The great sign from heaven will be the largest sign that has ever heralded a prophetic event. We are on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem. It is 3 in the morning on September 23, 2017. The first constellation in the great sign is rising above the horizon. This is Leo, the constellation of the Royal Lion. When the dawn breaks, we'll see that Leo is worn as a crown of royalty by the Virgin Princess. The lion forms the appropriate crown for her because she is of the house of David, the lion of the tribe of Judah. Significantly, this is the highest royal lineage of all the nations. This means the virgin is also born of the lineage of the high scepter of the seed of Adam. In her belly is the second Adam, the savior of the world. On this fateful day, the virgin is clothed in the sun, and the moon is at her feet. Sunlight floods the sky, and since the virgin is clothed in the sun, we cannot see her, so we turn off her artwork. But the prophecy clearly states that the great sign is to appear in the heaven. High noon approaches. Then, on this special day, the sun turns as black as sackcloth, and the stars quickly fill the sky. Just like on the day of the crucifixion, it will remain dark for an incredible 3 hours. We stop the motion and zoom in. We fill the screen with our two constellations. To better see how the constellations are formed, we generate blue lines between their stars. Then we turn off the constellation artwork, leaving us with the lines of each constellation. We first turn our attention to the constellation of Leo. In Leo, the alpha or brightest star is Regulus, the regal king star. 8 additional bright stars are used to form the constellation. But this leaves us 3 stars short of the 12 stars prophesied to crown the Virgin. On this special day, 3 wandering stars are in rare formation within the boundaries of Leo. They are Venus, Mars, and Mercury. This gives us the prophesied 12 stars to form the crown. Now we move to Virgo. Her left hip is formed by the alpha star named Spica, which means the seed. Her right hip is formed by the zeta star named Hes, which means the branch. On this day, the Virgin is to give birth to the king planet between these two stars. Like all the planets, Jupiter, which images the Messiah, was misnamed and misdescribed by the Greeks. The king planet images the rescuing power of our Messiah. Because of this planet's gravitational strength, it takes countless hits or impacts for us from many of the dangerous objects that cross into the inner solar system. Also, the king planet has just spent 9 months in the belly of the Virgin, reinforcing the prophetic imagery of the scriptures. To illustrate this wonder, we will now run the clock backward for a year. Notice that the king planet stops and turns around twice in retrograde motion while in the belly of the Virgin. In turn, the moon flies by along the ecliptic every month. This action by the moon will give us a means to mark the passing of the months. We stop our backward motion. We now change into forward motion. We pause the motion as Jupiter enters the belly of the Virgin. Now count the times that the moon flies by while Jupiter is in the Virgin's belly. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, and in just under 10 months, we arrive back at our fateful day, September 23rd, 2017. Now we will recap the prophetic imagery in the great sign. First, we have Virgo, the Virgin Princess, imaging the Virgin Mary. Second, the Virgin is clothed in the sun, imaging the life-giving Spirit of God. Third, the crescent moon is at her feet, heralding this day as the Jewish Feast of Trumpets. Fourth, on this day, the Virgin also has a special crown of 12 stars, representing the lineage of the high throne of the nation of Israel. Fifth, the Virgin gives birth to the crown prince, the Messiah. Sixth, the crown prince has just spent a long 9 months in her womb, the time of human gestation. Seventh, so we can see this wonder, a special heavenly event causes the sky to fall dark for 3 hours in the middle of the day. The combination of all 7 of these independent actions into a great sign brings to life the exact imagery of the prophecy. However, if this sign were to occur repeatedly in the course of the travels of the planets, then how could we interpret it as a significant event? How often does this configuration occur in the heavens? The answer, it occurs only this one time. At no other time is the Virgin clothed in the sun, with the moon at her feet, while she is wearing a crown of 12 stars, at the same time she gives birth. We have found no astronomy program that shows this configuration occurring at any other time throughout history, from the days of Adam, 6,000 years in the past, until the end of the millennial reign, 1,000 years into our future. Yet, this wonder was described in detail in Revelation chapter 12, nearly 2,000 years ago. The astounding fulfillment of this great prophecy is like a clarion blast of God's trumpet, broadcasting to all that the sign is a magnificent herald of end times events. Furthermore, its appearance is to occur on the exact day the Lord intends, a plan He laid out before He created the heavens. This means the great sign is an event that cannot be anything less than a miraculous herald of prophetic events. Furthermore, the imagery does not end with the first two verses we just read in Revelation 12. On this day, a famous comet carrying the Rosetta probe is beside the crescent moon. This comet bodes a day of disaster for the moon god of Islam. At noon, the foot of the Virgin is on one side of the moon, the comet is on the other. By the end of the day, the moon will be under the Virgin's feet. This day in 2017 is also unique for other reasons. As mentioned, this is the day of the Feast of Trumpets, one of the seven appointed feasts of the Lord. The seven feasts are prophetic of the seven most significant events in redemptive history. Jesus was crucified on the first spring feast. This is the day of the first fall feast. In turn, this day on this unique year is also on the weekly seventh-day Sabbath. Finally, it is also the day of the fall equinox. Incredibly, all of these date markers in the heavens are occurring on the same day on the Lord's calendar. The day progresses. At 3 in the afternoon, the eclipse will be over. The sun reappears and shines for 3 more hours before it sets in the west. At this point, the great wonder becomes the herald of great terror. The heavenly body that blocked the sun for 3 hours is immense enough to carry large debris rings of ice and sulfur, rings composed of material much like the rings of Saturn, only larger. Soon the earth must pass through one of these rings. This is when the firestorm of the Golden Empire occurs. It is the day of the death of Babylon the Great, which is the proud city of Sodom, which is the unrepentant empire, and 1 hour's time, 1/3 of mankind will die. Foreseeing the intensity of the hour, the Lord has foretold time and again that not one person who calls upon His name will be lost. The shouting in terror begins. Jerusalem will be safe from the firestorm because of the earth's rotation. In contrast, unmitigated disaster falls upon the Western world. And the Lord will call. To the core. One of God's great purposes for apocalyptic scripture is to shake us into realizing that our situation is serious and that we must take action before these events arrive in order to guard our souls and the souls of all those we love. Dawn in the shadow of Congress, it is the day of the great sign. Forerunners of the firestorm of the Golden Empire streak the sky. The end is within hours. The great sign in heaven heralds the world's entrance into end times troubles. God's grace is manifested in this sign. It has been created to warn us, flee from the wrath to come. The day of the anger of the Lamb is approaching, for the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? The only way for you to flee is to flee to the Lord. The wise men had the eyes to see that the Star of Bethlehem meant a prophetic day was upon them. They then acted on what they saw. Do you have the eyes to see that the great sign from heaven means a prophetic day is upon you? The most famous star of history was a herald of good news. In contrast, God is going to use the largest sign in history to herald terrifying news. The first herald called forth shouts of great joy. This second herald will call forth shouts of great terror. The great sign is so significant, there are at least three forerunner signs preparing the way for its appearance. The blood moon tetrad, the famous comet carrying the Rosetta probe, and the great American eclipse of 2017. Midway between the blood moons of 2014, the Caliphate of Islam was reborn. This event constitutes the birth of the little horn, the eighth prophetic king described in Revelation chapter 17. It will become the empire of the beast. The great comet carrying the Rosetta probe passed into the constellations of the great sign on the very day of the fourth blood moon, stitching together end time signs. It will remain in the great sign for 2 years and be beside the moon when the great sign appears, boding disaster for Allah and his new caliphate. The great American eclipse of August 21, 2017. This solar eclipse sweeps around half the earth but brings darkness to only one land, the United States of America. This is the final heads-up call to awaken. Cataclysmic judgment is only 33 days away. The Great American Firestorm will arrive 33 days after the Great American Eclipse of 2017. God's purpose of fearful sights and great signs from heaven is to bring many people who would not have done so otherwise to call upon the name of the Lord. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. God has designed special configurations among the stars to function as signs. They are signs that herald prophetic events on the earth. This heralding will serve notice before the eyes of the world that the time of events foretold by the Lord has arrived. All this means the great sign in heaven has full authority to function as a public event legally documenting the final great warning of God. The Lord is the great prophet. As a prophet, he is accountable to warn all who are under his ministry. The great wonder in heaven is his imminent and astounding warning to all. The time of judgment is here. This judgment is written in the book. This judgment is written in the stars. The prophets have warned you. This judgment is just. This means the Lord cannot be charged with any wrong against man or angel for the judgment he is bringing upon the world. You are served notice. The Lord's end times events are about to overtake you. The great sign in heaven is the colossal herald proclaiming that the prophetic troubles of the last days have arrived. Most of us refuse to believe God's work by faith, while we will believe his working through a sign. So God is going to give us a sign, a great sign. This great sign will herald sudden and great judgment. But why? The rebel lawmakers of the Golden Empire have foolishly attacked Christian purity. The attack on purity is because the lawmakers will not have holiness to rule over them. But to reject God's holiness is to reject God himself. In the end, the rebels' own reasoning forces them to declare war on God. As soon as the rebels feel bold enough, open war breaks out. In defiance, they reach out and seize their own court officers that are still walking in holiness. At this point, the spirit of Sodom overtakes the land. The Lord acts swiftly. The judgment of Sodom will be poured out on the spirit of Sodom. The Lord begins moving into place as storehouse for the day of battle. Like little David, all he needs is some rocks. The day of battle arrives. It is a day of fearful sights and great signs from heaven. The Lord takes aim, and the golden Goliath suddenly falls. The empire will die in 1 hour, unrepentant in its wickedness. The unrepentant empire and the church in the unrepentant empire have together refused to confess the empire's fatal sin. What is this fatal sin that brings such sudden judgment? Our fatal sin is the replacement of holiness with human rights as our guiding moral principle in life and government. This is in direct opposition to the Lord's decree, "You shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy." The manifest insanity of pornographic rights, abortion rights, and homosexual rights is the diseased fruit of the doctrine of human rights. This is why evil has become good, and good has become evil in our land. The unrepentant adherence to the doctrine of human rights that is producing the trampling of the holiness of God in our courts is the guarantee of the firestorm of the Golden Empire. Your only hope will be to turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. For Jesus himself said, "As earnestly as I can say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." In the same conversation with Nicodemus, Jesus also said, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Call on his name with all your heart. Please do not risk one day's wait. Everyone, pray out loud with me, even if you're already born again. Decide now and say this prayer. Jesus, I cry out to you. I admit I am a sinner, fallen and under your judgment. In confusion, I have replaced your holiness with man's counterfeit. I want to be born again and to see rightly. Rescue me from your firestorm and send your Holy Spirit to dwell in me. Amen. Now try out your spiritual eyes, find a Bible, and read the Gospel of John. It is the fourth book in the New Testament.